师父蛮OK，眼睛还看得见。<笑>不过工作的时候是要戴那个老花眼啊，就比较轻松一点。没有的话，看得比较辛苦；有的话，看得比较简单，就可以站着坐着停，就不用蹲下来看，懂吗？那个背痛已经要算了啊，OK。<笑>所以我还是每天算自己的福报了啊。哎呀，有一些人诅咒还活着呢，吃东西不怎么样，有手吃有手没吃。 <笑>有时候吃很多，像今天那个样子。<笑>我今天你们来，我就紧张了，<笑>好几天没睡觉嘛，然后又累了，我就想吃一下，不然就爬不下去了。吃一下喝一下，那种茶了，精神有一点啊。结果吃了就自己煮是比较好吃，自己煮刚好煮稀饭嘛，啊，然后吃那些什么那个什么黄瓜啦，在台湾弄那个。
酱瓜是吗？是黄瓜的，对了。不过它放在罐头里面有没有？啊，我们去别的地方，不然人家嫉妒啊。<笑>好好。然后呢，好久没有吃稀饭了，因为好久没时间煮那种那么热的，马上吃那种，懂不懂？哎，有时候就简单从冰箱拿出来的，吃不多。今天怎么搞得吃的好多？ 刚好今天不应该吃那么多，都是这样啊，了解吗？就像你们有时候又想准时去见某些人，哦，搞不晓得为什么就忘了，忘记等一下时间就慢掉了，是不是这样啊？哎，每次看到你们都有什么障碍的，今天就障碍就是食物，我自己煮，<笑>我自己煮好吃嘛，热热的刚好热的，然后从昨天没吃嘛就。 就好吃了啊，就至少都忘记了啊。不过我本来就穿松松衣服，有没有？这种衣服好久不见了啦，啊，这种印尼来的，然后他们挂在那里很，我下来刚好他就在面前了，懂吗？哎，平常是找很久才找到东西啊，因为他挂很多很多，啊，今天这个是在我面前的，哈哈，笑容了啊，就我说好这个。 这不错，我认为跟平常我穿那种松松的衣服一样啊，看起来大大宽宽的，挂起来的时候就是这样，一转起来说，哎 ，My God， <笑>我穿的时候我就觉得，哎呦，怎么办呢？现在怎么办？哦，来不及了，算了算了，<笑>然后挂这个前面呢，盖一下那个，盖一下那个布景那种，布景那种什么。 看到了啊，只有女孩子能看的。OK， <笑>那个扣子嘛，那好了，都是台湾的啦啊，台湾东西好吃才这样。嗯，<笑>来，谢谢。嗯，我是跟台湾比较有缘嘛。OK 啊，<笑>好好啊，Thank you， 谢谢谢谢谢谢，我不能整天走了，所以这样象征而已。OK 呀。 啊，你好，你好啊！因为我刚来台湾的时候都不认识任何人，然后就钱也没有了，出家嘛有没有？然后什么衣服啊、装饰品那些了，耳环啊、耳环、手环，什么全部都给人家，然后去喜马拉雅山的时候才发现得到钱没有，<笑>啊。 钱没有，然后当然回台湾也没有，了解吗？有一点点而已。然后就有一个台湾的小姐嘛，那个时候她叫廖小姐了，她帮师傅翻译了。刚来的时候我不讲中文嘛，她讲英文很好，她每次都帮师傅翻译，然后她就也是供养师傅一些钱啊什么的。 饭啊，菜什么的啊，还有一个，他们两个以后是同修了，嗯，刚来的时候不是，就是他看我出家人，国外人啊，啊，穿衣服破破烂烂的，没钱了、啊，就给我，啊，然后还有一个师姐每天煮饭给我吃，<笑>啊，所以那个连一个人的福报哈、啊。
一个两个三个人的福报也可以给全国那种福报的，懂不懂？结缘的啊，所以我们也要感谢他们呐、啊。OK， 那早期那几个 ，OK， 嗯、啊、嗯。修行的人哈、啊，在哪里有人家拥护的，懂不懂？啊，受到恩惠了，是要在那边继续啊教导他们，嗯、啊，也是算一种。嗯，有来有去的啊，报答的，嗯，一两个人做福报而已，整国家就会有那种那受化啊。一个人一两个人做业障的话，也是同样相反的。缘分有两种嘛 ，OK， 一种就是你给他们的东西，嗯、啊，一种是你收容他们的东西，嗯、啊，两个都会结缘的。我看。哪一个缘分就结哪一个缘分就对了，也不一定去哪里都要拿东西才结缘的。所以像释迦牟尼佛在世的时候，他有讲过他过去的故事嘛，啊，连自己身体啊、肉啊、水也要供养给别众生，才能够跟他们结缘的，到这种程度，了解吗？嗯，然后有一些是供养他，也福报也好多。供养的人的话。就会很快修行，跟着他的时候修行比较顺比较舒服，嗯，伤害他的话就比较困难。其实纵然碰到佛还是一样，有时候会背叛的，懂不懂？有时候也被业障盖住啊，然后还是做不对的事情。释迦牟尼佛贡献他的身体啊、过程啊、句子啊，是自愿的，就不一样，懂不懂啊？不是被人伤害的，他拿他自己的水啊、自己肉给众生吃，是自愿的，那个不一样啊。如果我们强迫或是我们伤害他，就不一样了。你看像耶婆达陀啊，他生生世世都是没怎么样，懂不懂？像上下地狱跟人家去买菜一样，还没有学会。不过这个世界是这样了，有因就有阳哈 ，OK， 什么我们都可以接受的，为了终生福报，嗯，很好，嗯 ，OK， yeah， 对不起，我老了，不能整个绕了 ，OK， 看电视嘛，嗯，而且刚吃饭呢，懂吗？走路，走路也比较重了，OK。那、啊、以后我知道了，以后你们来我就不吃饭了，嗯，昏倒就给他昏了，嗯，不管他了。How come you guys sit there? You like it there? Or you don't like it here? Hey, come up. Yeah, come up here. I'm very small. I go like this. You come up. Three of you. Come. Look, you see how I go? Oh, you can sit both of you. What size?Hey, how are you guys? Okay, good. Come here, honey. Sweetheart, there are places in the front, places here. Yeah. Don't worry, I am very small. My stomach is big, but I'm still small. You can also sit up here if there's not comfortable. There's a lot of places.Yeah, I don't know why they make such a big place. I'm small one and she's a big one. They want my kingdom big, that's why. Huh? Yes. Yeah, have a look, okay? Your airplane ticket money is sitting here for you. Sorry. Maybe with your good merit, you will have a bigger...meditation place soon.、Mm? I'm working on it. Every country, even the most freedom protecting country like Taiwan, also has rules and regulations. This is as good as it gets already. Okay? Yes. So we have to thank God for everything we have. Yeah. Even not much, but, you know, it's cool, right?
Yes.
Some people say, well, why I let you come here without any rooms or any house, any comfort. But it's okay to have a picnic now and then, no? At home, sometimes you also pack your tent, you know, a long time ago. Pack your tent, go to the park with your kids or your friend, sit on the floor on the cloth, right? And have barbecue, no? And eat your stuff out in the fresh air, on the grass. So this is just like a picnic for you. I don't know why somebody complained. Anybody complained? Better not. Yes, some people do, but never mind about that. I know most of you are happy to be here.
Yes.
You are much better off than when I was in India. In India, I had no tent even. Yeah, if there was a roof, you know, like a corridor outside with a roof, then I would sit under it and sleep under it. If not, I just cover it with my coat, you know, outer coat. It's like when you're cold, you have it. Yeah? So I just put a chair, you know. In any ashram, they would have a chair, spare somewhere. And I just sat on that chair. And in the corner of the balcony, you know, any balcony they have corner, yeah? Okay, I sat right at the corner. I covered with the coat at the corner. I sat on the chair. And that was my house. Yeah, and a little, whatever little luggage I had, I put in the front. So if I fell down, I didn't fall right onto the cement, but boom, onto my luggage, yeah? Saved my head. Not too bad, not that stupid. I know everything. And then if I didn't have money and I went around sometimes to visit some holy shrine or holy places, I went almost the whole of India. I don't remember the names. Then I just put the umbrella, you know. I had a small folding umbrella. I put a red umbrella out and the rain came out and not down, yeah. Or the dew, whatever, yeah, okay. It was a very cheap tent, and you had it everywhere with you. And I never felt like that was very ascetic or anything like that. I felt very happy at that time. I'm happy now also that I can do some service to humans and non-humans. I'm also very happy about that, that I'm able to, okay, that I'm allowed to, that I empowered to do it. I'm very happy too. But at that time it was different. It was more carefree. Carefree. I slept when I wanted. I ate when I was hungry. Yeah. And I walk around when I felt like exercising my feet or my body. Yes. Many things are still free in life. Even in the Himalayas, I had a chiropractor treat me free. I had no problems. It was just anybody he liked. He said, come, I give you a massage. Yeah, he just did it for free. He went on holiday in the Himalayas. At that time, I was in Rishikesh. And I live in a little mud house. Yeah, you pay rent, but very cheap. And I cooked chapati every day with some peanut butter and some wild, wild leaves that I found around me, yeah? I was very happy, so carefree, you know? And then in the morning, I went to the Ganges River, took a shower, bath, and then got some. There was even free running water, like a small waterfall, eh? Yeah. Went there every day to wash my clothes. And I went to the Ganges River just for a little pat-pat. Yeah, life was really cool. I was happiest at that time. You're happy, you don't even know that you're happy because there's nothing sad about anything, so you don't think about it. Only after I left it, then now it's so burdened or busy every day and night, a lot of work and a lot of responsibility. Then sometimes I have nostalgic feelings about that kind of life. It was so free, so free. In India, you don't need a lot of money to stay alive. I ate very simple, just chapati, made it myself. In just a very little plate like that, you can use it to cook water and cook chapati too. And peanut butter, yeah? And some cucumber, just something like that. That kind of life is so good. Hmm. And in that kind of area, you are free. You feel also free because the energy there is not like in the city. And not a lot of people. There are some people who came for pilgrimage, you see? So they are sincere. Their heart is pure. And people who live there are also very pure because they don't go down to the plain, you know, with the hustle, bustle, the competitiveness of life. They stay far away from it. And that place is, since long time, it's like a shrine, a natural shrine for the practitioners. A Buddha went there, many masters went there. Yeah. Some famous masters are still there or from there or went there to establish themselves. So the energy is just very light, simple. Mm. Even you don't do anything, you feel good. You don't even feel that you feel good. You're just living, you know, freely, just have no care in the world. And I ate only chapati and peanut butter and sometimes a little samosa, you know. That was my favorite. At that time, that was my weakness. So. So I didn't have money to have more every day, just one. Very small, very, very small. About the size of my wrist, about this much, you know, very small. Some chapati, some of them made it bigger, but that one, very small, very small. And I couldn't only afford one a day, but sometimes, I could not help it. I ate 2, 3, and then 1 week, I could not have anything. No cucumber, understand? And less chapati, and less other walking instead of going on the horse ride. Yeah, somehow you can manage, can be flexible with your money. Mm.